let's see the first question. So the question says, suppose we initialize the array like int a of 5 equals 10 comma 20 comma 30. Now the most important thing that we have to understand here, we have the array of size 5 elements or 5 integers, out of which we are initializing the first 3 integers. So we can draw this array in this way. So let's say this is my array whose name is A, which can consist of 5 integers, and out of 5 integers only first 3 integers initialized. Now the most important thing that you have to keep in mind is, whenever we initialize at least one element of an array, all the remaining elements will be automatically initialized to 0. Now here the element at the index 0, at index 1 and index 2 are initialized to 10, 20 and 30 respectively, and hence all the remaining elements of an array will be automatically initialized to 0. So I can say the element at index 3 and the element at index 4 will be initialized to 0 automatically. So the answer to this question will be the option D, that's last two elements of the array will be initialized to 0. Now as you can see here we have the nesting of the ternary operators. Now the question is, which combination of the integer variable, that's A, B and C, make the variable M to get the value of 4. Okay. Now in this case, if you want to solve this particular example, then we have to solve it by considering all the options. So let's consider the option number 1. So what we have here, A is 5, B is 4 and C is 5. Now what we do here, if we A is greater than B, then we have to check whether A is greater than C also. Now if it is so, we are returning the A, otherwise we are returning the C. Then in this case we have to check, if B is greater than C, then we are returning the B, otherwise we want to return the C. Okay. So what we can say here is, here we have to find out the largest of the A, B and C. So let's try to see here. So if A is greater than B, so 5 is greater than 4, so I can say we have to execute this particular part. So if A is greater than C, so which is a false condition, so I can say in this case this condition will become false. Okay. So I want to go to this particular part. Now it says whether B is greater than C. Now B is 4 and C is 5, so I can say this condition will be false, so it will return a C, so it will return 5. So this condition can be wrong. Okay, so I'll erase this part now. Now let's consider the option number 2. Note it says A is 6, B is 3 and C is 5. So if A is greater than C, then it will return 6, otherwise it will return 5. If B is greater than C, this condition is false, so it will return the value of C only, that's 5. Let's see the option C here. If A is greater than C, then it will return A, otherwise it will return C. Okay. So as you can see, there is nowhere the option 4 present within the option B or C, so I can directly neglect all these options. Okay. And we also know option A is not the answer because we have solved it. Now let's see it for the option D. So if A is greater than C, if A is greater than B, then I need to check whether A is greater than C also. But A is 3 and C is 2, which is the wrong thing. So I can say this part will not execute. Now the comparison has to be done between B and C. So B is greater than C. Okay, so here B is 4 and C is 2. It means B is greater than C, so it will return the value of B, and the value of B here is 4. Okay, so I can say the correct answer for this question is option D. It will return the value of B, which is 4, and hence it will be assigned to the M. Okay, so as I said already, this is basically the program to find out the largest number between A, B and C. and you have to check for the largest number between the A, B and C with the largest value as 4. Hence, I can say the option D is the right answer. So, I have shown you both the ways how you can understand the meaning of this statement and solve it directly, or you can directly put the values one by one inside the expression and then you can solve it. Now, this is the question from the SDLC. It asks the tool that depicts the progress of the task against the time is basically called as the Gantt chart. So, in the project management, there is a Gantt chart which depicts the progress of the tasks against the times. Now, here we have one more question from the Java. So, what it says, we have the static int sample method and we have the ternary operator. So, if it is true, it is going to return this particular part. So, I can say the static int sample is going to return a null. Okay, it's going to return null. Now, we know internally null is nothing but the zero. Okay, and now if we see here, okay, we are actually trying to access main.sample. Okay, so we are actually trying to access the null here. Now, when we try to access null, what we'll actually get is basically a runtime error, okay, and that's basically called as null pointer exception. So, the answer here is the option C, will get a runtime error. Now, here we have a code which consists of the string array. Now, always remember string array is nothing but the two dimensional array. So, here we have char star name which consists of the strings. So, let's say this is a name array and it consists of how many strings? 4 strings. So, this string number 1, this is string number 0, string number 1, string number 2 and string number 3. Now, each string consists of the subarray, okay, or the array of characters, because we know a string is the array of characters. So, the first string is A, B, C. So, I can say this is 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2. Then we have D, E, F. So, this is 0, 1. Sorry, so this will be 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 2 then we have G H I, so this will be 2 0 2 1 and 2 2 and this will be J K L, so this will be 3 0 3 1 and 3 2. Now here we are trying to access the value at the index 2 plus 2. So, what is the index 2 from the name array? So, this is my name array. So, the index 2 from the name array is this G H I. Okay. Now, if I simply write star name of 2, okay, it will simply display the entire string, that's G H I. Okay. But what I'm doing here, star name of 2 plus 2 plus 2. It means go at the index 2 of name array and count the character at the index 2. So, we know at second index of the char star array name, we have to get again the second index. So, this is index number 0, index number 1 and this is the index number 2, okay, which gives me the character as I. So, this will give me the output as I. Now, here we have a question based on a linked list which says, in a doubly circular linked list, what will be the contents of the right field of the last node? Now, we know since it's a doubly circular linked list, it will point to the first node again. So, we can say the contents of the right address of the last node will again contains the address of the first node. So, option C will be the correct answer in this case. Now, here we have one more question from Java which says we have the int a 1, 2. So, I can say 1 is available at index 0 and 2 is available at index 1. Now when I print system.out.println, it will print hello. Then it will print space because there is space here. Then at the next line, it will print user, okay, without any space. And below that, it will print the element inside the array A at index 1. Now we have the element here as 2. So we can say at the next line, it will print 2. So the contents are hello space at line 1, user at line 2, and 2 at line 3. Now here we have a question based on a bubble sort. So if we sort the given elements by using a bubble sort, then in a third pass or iteration, how many comparisons should be performed? Okay, so we know for a bubble sort, the comparisons are done for as n minus 1 for the first pass, n minus 2 for the second pass, and n minus 3 for the third pass, and so on. Now n here is nothing but the number of elements inside an array, or we can say size of an array. So here we can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 elements are there inside an array. So at third iteration, we have total number of comparisons as 5 minus 3, that is nothing but 2. So correct option here is option D. For this particular array, in order to sort it by using the bubble sort, we require total 2 comparisons at the third iteration. Okay, so here we have programming problem statement number 1. It says a marathon 1S, a long distance race with an official distance of 42.195 kilometers. Usually run as a road race or a foot race. A local marathon was organized at Bawdhan, Pune. The distance actually covered by the participants has been recorded in an array R, which is an integer holding the values in kilometers. Now here they have said us we have to create an array of integers which holds the values in the kilometers, but the important thing is the distance that they have actually given consists of the fractional distance. So what we can do here is we have to take the array of either float or array of either doubles. Now if there are n number of participants who started running at a particular time, then the size of array R is n. So for each of the participant we are going to store the distance. So we can say the size of the array which is going to store the distance of each participants is equal to the number of participants present inside the race or participated inside a race. Now the participant should cover a distance more than 0.0 kilometers to get recorded in array R. Now find the maximum distance covered by the highest racers excluding the finisher. Now the most important thing, the finisher will cover all the distance. So I can say the distance covered by the finisher is 42.195. So we have to calculate the participants who has covered the highest distance other than finisher. So we can call it as max 1, then the max 2, then we have the max 3. Okay, so max 1 will be the highest distance covered, or we can say the topmost distance covered other than finisher. Then max 2 is the second highest distance covered other than the finisher, and max 3 is the third highest distance covered than the finisher. Okay, now we have to return all the three maximum distances excluding the finishing distance D, where D is equal to 42.195 kilometers. Now the input values are: enter the distance covered by the racers in the marathon and press Q to terminate. Now the most important thing is if we want to press Q to terminate, whatever the distance that we are going to scan that must be scanned as a string first, and then we have to convert that string into either float or a double. Because if you want to identify the keystroke Q, we have to identify the keystroke in form of the string. Okay, so what we'll do here, we'll scan each and everything in form of the string, and then we'll cover it in terms of the float or a double. Okay, so let's try to see it step by step. So I'll open the dev C++. Now here what they said here, as we have the participants which are taking part in a marathon. So I'm going to write a C code for that. So we'll write a main function here and let's save it as 1.c. Now what they said is the distance measured in terms of the kilometer. So highest distance or the finisher distance is 42.195 kilometer. So I can say double finisher is equal to 42.195 kilometers. Then what we are doing here, we are going to store the distance covered by every participants, the distance covered by every participant inside the array R. But here we don't know the prior size of array, okay, because we are going to stop taking the values only after user presses the queue. Okay, so what we can say here is we want to have the double array R here, okay, and the size of this particular R, I'll take 100, by supposing that maximum 100 participants can participate. Now, as we already said, we have to stop taking the input whenever the user enters the queue. So whatever the input that we want to scan, we have to scan it in form of the string. So I can say character, I'll say dist of let's say 20, okay, which is used to scan the distance, and in order to avoid the garbage, I'm going to initialize to 0. So similarly, the array also I'm going to initialize to 0. Now what we have to do is we have to scan every distance from the user, and whenever user enters the queue, we are going to break it. Okay, so how we can write here is we'll write an infinite while loop, and I can say I'm going to scan the input in form of the string inside the array. That's a string array that basically says a distance. Okay, now what we know here is if dist equals q, then we have to break. Now in order to do the string comparison, we need to include string.h. So we'll call it as string.h should be included, and I can compare if string compare of the distance array or the distance string with the q matches, then I'm going to break the loop. Okay, so I'm going to stop taking the input. Okay, otherwise I can put this particular value inside an array. Okay, so what I can say here, in order to put it inside an array, I require some variable n which will store the size of the array. So I'll initialize the value of n as 0, and then I can say the r of n plus plus is equal to the dist. Okay, now the biggest problem here is the dist is in form of the string, while the array is basically made up of the double elements. Okay, so it's a numeric and it's a string, so I need to have some function which converts the string to double, and we know we have such a function inside a library stdlib.h. so I'm going to use the stdlib.h library, and then we can have this particular function here. Okay, and the function is called as a2f. So function converts a given string into a fractional value. Okay, now just in order to confirm whatever the input that we have taken is correct or not, we have to write a for loop just to confirm whatever the values that we are taking are working correctly or not. So for writing a for loop, I require one iterator I, and I'll write a for loop by using the iterator. Now here you can see for every valid input I'm going to increment n by 1. So I can say the n here will give me the size of an array or the number of elements in an array. Now what we can do here is we'll write a for loop which will go from 0 to n, that's size of an array or size of the participants, and we can print the distance traveled by every participant. Now since it's a double distance, I'll use %LF, okay, on the screen. So I can say R of I. So just compile here. So I made a spelling mistake. So hash include. So let's compile here and run the code. Now what I can do here is I can simply copy this input. So let me go here and I'll copy this input. I'll minimize it and I'll paste it here and then I'll press Q. Now as you can see, first three are 42.195, then we have 33.25, then we have 40.0041, something like that. Then we have 38.900, then we have 37.500. Okay, so we can say all the values that we have entered are taken correctly. Now the most important thing that we want to do is we have to calculate the finisher which has covered the higher distance. Sorry, not the finisher, but the participants which has covered higher distance or highest distance other than the finisher. So let's call this as max1, max2 and max3. Now initially we don't know the distance, so that's why I can say the distance cannot be negative. So in order to make or identify the invalid values, I'll say max1 has covered minus 1 distance. Since max2 has covered lesser distance than max1, I'll assign minus 2 to this. And since max3 has covered lesser distance than max2, I can assign minus 3 value to this. So I have three values, max1, max2, max3, okay, which denotes the highest distance covered participants other than the finisher. Now we have to calculate the topmost participant distance that has covered other than finisher. Now what can be the condition for this? So I can say in order to be the topmost distance covered participant, I can say the max one, okay, the max one, I can say the corresponding distance inside the array R at index I should be less than the finisher, because that they have specified, and at the same time the R of I should be greater than the max one. Okay, so if it is so, we can say that my new max one will become the element in an array R at index I. But before that, if previously max1 is present there and we have found the new max1, then whatever the previous max1 is there, that will become max2, and whatever the previous max2 is there, that will become max3. So before that, I can say max3 is nothing but previous max2, and previous max2 is nothing but this max2 is nothing but the previous max1, and this max1 is nothing but the current element which is greater than the max1 and less than the finisher. Else I can say if the error of I is greater than the max2, I can say whatever the previous max2 is there, that need to be assigned to max3. So I can say max3 is equal to max2 and new max2 is equal to the current element inside an array R. So I need to write if condition here. Okay, then I can say else if the current element inside the array R is greater than the max 3, then we can say max 3 is equal to the current element, that's R of I. So when we finish all the iteration of the given file loop, given for loop, we'll have the final values of max 1, max 2 and max 3, which denotes the highest distant cover participants other than the finisher. So I'll simply add a printf outside of for loop. Now since I want to show three values, I'll use 3%lf or three format specifiers. Okay, we'll add a comma just to show these values separated by comma on the standard output, and I'll simply write max 1, then max 2 and max 3. That's it. Now let's try to compile it. So as you can see, the program compiles with zero errors and zero warnings, and let's try to run it. Now this time we'll copy the input here. So simply click on copy and we'll paste the input and then we'll press the Q. Now as you can see, the topmost participants other than finisher are 41.2, 40.0 and 38.9. Okay, so let's see how they want to display it. So here you can see the highest distance excluding finisher as 41.2, 40.0 and 38.9. So they want to display it up to two decimal places. Okay, and they want to add this particular line. So I'll simply copy this line rather than writing it. So I'll close the output window and we'll modify the program in this way. So I can say the highest distance excluding the finisher are percent, I can say 0.2lf, okay. Now let's try to compile this. Okay, before that we want to copy the input here. So I'll simply press Ctrl C and we'll run the code and paste this and we'll type Q. Okay, now as you can see, the highest distance excluding the finisher is 41.2, 40 and 38.9, okay, which is the expected output that we have. So this is how we can solve the given code in an efficient manner. So this is the code.